What's going on, everyone? It's Marsellis back with another video, and we have to go over something today. So today is going to be a little different. We're not going to be talking about a crypto, but actually we are going to be talking about a stock. So the stock today that we are talking about is MGM Resorts International, and they actually have some really big news that just happened today, a really big partnership that's going to help them. And actually, let's go over that partnership before we go over this technical here, right? So the partnership here is MGM Resorts. All right, so BetMGM partners with PFL. So PFL, if you don't know, it's an MMA thing. It's PFL MMA, Professional Fighting League. And yeah, they're pretty much an MMA company. They do a bunch of stuff in Las Vegas and all over the world pretty much. And remember, MGM is based out of Las Vegas, so that is where all the gambling's happens, where a lot of UFC fights happen. It's where a lot of MMA fights in general happen. You know, Bellator has some fights there, and we have UFC and PFL, which we just now got a new partnership with MGM Stocks, or not MGM Stocks, and you know, MGM Resorts. But over here is the PFL YouTube channel. They have all types of fight here. So there's so many different fights here. Look at this, 10 million views. They get a lot of views on YouTube, so that is something big to look at here. And they have a lot of different fighters, so a lot of different videos here, you know, a lot of different views. You go over here, total, they have 99 million views. There's about to be another big fight tonight. Look at this, between these two ladies here, Shields and Elkin. They're supposed to be fighting tonight at Thursday, June 10th, and they're most likely going to be fighting at one of the MGM resorts, or they're probably, you know, staying inside of one of the resorts, because remember, these resorts are like, they're like training gyms. You know, they have gyms inside of these resorts, and they use these as like fighter gyms, you know, sports gyms. That's what they usually call them. But yeah, we have some big news here, because PFL, you know, making a lot of money. A lot of money is going through PFL. People are buying those tickets, and now they're collabing with MGM. So that's going to put a lot of money through this stock right now. As you can see, MGM right here, $42.67. Let's go ahead and look MGM Resorts on Yahoo Finance, so we can go ahead and look at all of our market cap. All right, so MGM Resorts, let's just look up the stock instead of the actual website. So yeah, let's just look up the stock. We don't have to go all the way to Yahoo Finance for this. All right, and then over here, MGM stock. All right, good. Now we have all the information up here. So look at this, $43. We know it's $42.67 though, but that's what the previous close was. So let's go here. Market cap, $20 billion. So the market cap is at $20 billion. Remember all the cryptos that we've talked about on this channel, they have a like really huge market caps, and they make a lot of gains, and this market cap is right up around there. So this market cap is huge right here. They make a lot of gains, a lot of money is flowing through MGM. So let's go over here to the technicals now that we went over our new partnership with PFL. So it says PFL fans will now be able to place bets on BetMGM, starting with PFL 4 airing on June 10th in prime time on ESPN networks. So yeah, part of the partnership, MGM can use PFL logos. So yeah, PFL right here, they're placing bets on BetMGM. So Matt Prevost, chief revenue officer of BetMGM, stated, so the upcoming PFL state is phenomenal, and we look forward to offering fans exciting opportunities. So yeah, you can now bet on BetMGM. So this is really big here. The partnership is going to help bring a lot of money through MGM. Like, there's going to be a lot of betting, a lot of stuff, and a lot of fights about to go on. So a lot of different stuff is going on here. Let's look at our chart. So, all right. So right here, this is where the pandemic started, right? So before we even get to all this growth, let's go back over here, pre-pandemic. So pre-pandemic here, you can see February 2016. You see it right here at the bottom of the screen. February 2016 to 22nd of February, right? And then we go all the way up here for literally 4 years straight, or 2 years straight, from 2016 all the way up to 2018. 2 years straight on an uptrend, like 2 years straight on a trend line here, positive trend line. That's really good for a stock. Like, most stocks don't do that. They don't go 2 years straight on a positive trend line. So obviously we had to, you know, do a little correction after that, because we had 2 years of nothing but straight growth. And then you go over here, and then it had to go down a little bit. It had to have a little dip. So, you know, it had a little, you know, a year, a half of a year for a dip, right? And then it was like, okay, we had a little correction. Now let's go back on the positive trend line. So this positive trend line would have lasted 2 years like it did previously. But the reason it didn't is because the pandemic. So we were projected to go up, 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 and up just like this on another trend line. But the reason we didn't do it is because the pandemic. So then when the pandemic hit, everything dropped. We went all the way down to $6 or $5.88. and then it jumps all the way back to $642. All right, so now look at the uptrend that we just now had going all the way up here. That's a huge uptrend. You want to know what I think this is about to do? This trend right here was the trend that we were supposed to have pre-pandemic. But post-pandemic, now you see everything that's happening. Now look at this. We were supposed to, you know, go up here on this uptrend. Now look at what the uptrend is doing. It's still going on that same uptrend from 2018, from actually the beginning of 2018, the beginning of 2019. It's still going on that same uptrend here. Look at that. The pandemic, yeah, it stopped it for a little bit, but it came right back up because this stock is a solid stock. So the reason why it came back up to its trend line is because it's a solid stock. Now we're going to continue to rise here on this. Look at this. It's going to continue to rise on a positive uptrend for the next 2 years or whatever. Remember, I'm not a financial advisor. This is not financial advice. But remember, when the pandemic ended the first time, not even ended the first time, but when the pandemic started the first time, that's why it dropped so much. And remember, we're nearing the end of the pandemic. So we are about to have even more growth than what we already had. So yeah, this is pretty much all I have for it right now is what we're seeing here. But let's go ahead and look at other stuff, the other fundamentals that will help us grow inside of the stock. So look at this, 28 resorts, endless entertainment for collab inquiries, please reach out. So endless entertainment, well, they have all these fighters showing up, you know, it's a sports economy over there. You know, a lot of different things happening in Vegas with MGM resorts. So this is huge right now. They have other stuff that's going on other than PFL. So that's what we also have to take note to. Remember the NHL, National Hockey League. So look at this. It's game day. Knights fans, gold, platinum, and NOR in life rewards. Members can take advantage of complimentary valet parking. And like you see, they are also partnered with the NHL. So they are partnered with the National Hockey League and now with PFL, the Professional Fighting League. Like they are the tops thing for sports centers. Like this is the top resort for sports centers and it has so many people going to it. And USA Basketball, like look at this, another basketball league, official partner of USA Basketball. Like they have a lot of different partners and they really, you know, dominate the sports sector. They really dominate it really well too. So this is just what we're seeing here temporarily. Remember these kind of partnerships, I'm not going to say that they end quickly, but these partnerships, you know, they'll last probably about a year. They probably signed a contract for like a year or two. So they're going to have some good stuff going on for the next year or two. Like I said, these 2 years right here from 2016 to 2018, positive. And now we're seeing the same thing that's about to happen. So here from 2019 all the way to 2021, we didn't have that whole positive run because of the pandemic. But now that we're back at these levels, we're still on our uptrend. So you can see we just came right back to our uptrend. We're touching the trend line literally every single time. That's how we know that we are on a uptrend. Touches the trend line, does not go below the trend line. Higher lows. And same thing, higher highs, higher lows, higher highs. So we're seeing some big things going on here. Same thing is going to start going on here. Higher lows, and then we're going to start getting these higher highs, and we're going to keep going until, you know, there's a little consolidation that leads us back to the trend line, and then we'll go back up. So this is what we're seeing inside MGM Resorts. So 13 best Las Vegas hotels. So they're showing you their the best Las Vegas hotels, the Mandalay Bay, all these different stuff. They have a lot of different hotels, suites, a lot of different Vegas suites. A lot of money is flowing through there. I mean, it's crazy what's going on there. And this is their official website. So Bruno Mars VIP experience. They even have Bruno Mars at their resort. So go figure. They have a lot of different stuff that's going on. So MGM Resorts to host USA Basketball. We already said that, but we didn't say the date. July 6th to the July 18th in Las Vegas. So that's going to be really nice there. USA Basketball and MGM Resorts International, a leader in the sports and entertainment industry, today announced an expanded multi-year partnership tipping off this July in Las Vegas. As part of the partnership, MGM Resorts will be the official training camp home of the USA Basketball team for men and women. All right, so they're literally going to be the home for them. Their international resorts are, it's like a whole sports theater there. Like it's a whole sports event anytime you go to one of those resorts. So this thing is crazy. The USA women are guided by head mentor Don Stoudy, South Carolina, and assistant coaches Dan Hughes. And as you can see, even PFL, they have the fighting league for the women too. So there is a lot of different things that are going on there. I want everybody to check this stock out. But remember, I'm not a financial advisor and this is not financial advice. I'm not telling y'all to invest in this, but I definitely do believe that they're doing well here for the sports industry and they're doing well for the resort industry, you know, for the traveling. So if you want to travel over to Las Vegas, go over there, go ahead and rent one of their hotels. I mean, rent one of their suites. I don't know if they're only renting them out to, you know, athletes or not, but it is an athlete resort. So check that out. This stock is going to go crazy now that this is happening. And also another thing, look over here, resort CEO and customers appetite for Las Vegas is amazing at this point. As you know, a lot of people have been moving from California to Las Vegas. A lot of people have been moving from LA specifically to Las Vegas because of the tax. So that's something big that's going on. Let's read what we have here. So Bill Hornbuckle, I guess he's the CEO. That's a weird name right there. Bill Hornbuckle, the CEO of MGM Resorts International, knows his way around Las Vegas. He earned an undergraduate degree in hotel administration at the University of Las Vegas, Nevada, and he began working in the casino industry there in the late 1970s. Barron sat down with Hornbuckle, 63-year-old, last month in his office and talked about this resort on the Strip. So this is huge. He's been around since 1970s. I mean, he's been in the casino industry, in the Vegas industry, since 1970s. So like he's really solidified in Vegas. Like he's the real G out there in Vegas. He's definitely the one you want to look up to if you're going out there in Vegas. And I'm definitely going to invest in his stock because it seems like he really knows what he's doing. And this stock has been going crazy. Remember, I'm not a financial advisor. This is not financial advice. But if you like this video, go ahead and hit the like button, subscribe, and check out the link in the description for a free stock with Robinhood and Webull. And for a limited time only, Robinhood will be giving you 3 free stocks and Webull will be giving you 4 free stocks if you sign up. So definitely sign up for that, and I'll be back with another video. Peace.